If you have a clog in your Robo E3 Pro, the first thing you should do is make sure your extruder is preheated. Once your extruder has reached its full temperature, you can start by trying the unclogging tool. To do so, simply push it down into the extruder. If it won't go, that means the clog is preventing it from going through the machine. Another thing you can try is heating the end of the unclogging tool with a lighter. This can sometimes help melt the filament from the top as well as the bottom. So get the tip of the unclogging tool very, very hot, and then try again. If filament comes out the bottom, you may have cleared your clog. If it's still clogged, there are a few additional steps you can take. Remove the unclogging tool by pushing on the side lever, pushing down, and then pulling up. It may require some force. If your clog still persists, use an Allen wrench to remove the cover of your extruder. To do so, there are three screws you'll need to undo. Two on the top, and one in this opening at the front. Once they're loose, the housing should simply lift up and out of the way. From here, you can take a look and see any filament that may be stuck in your extruder. And to remove it, you can try to pull it from here, but it probably won't do much yet. So what we're going to do is remove the motor block from the extruder. To do that, look for the two screws on the bottom of the extruder. You'll access them from the front. One is on the right, one is on the left. And when they've been loosened, you can simply pull this contraption back out of the way. Now, if there's filament stuck in there, like you can see with mine, you may have to try to lift as you pull it out of the way. Make sure you've fully loosened those screws. If you have filament caught in the end of the motor like this, you'll need to pull it out and remove it. Sometimes simply pushing on this side lever can give you enough space to pull the filament out, but if it gets stuck like mine is, simply use needle nose pliers or wire clippers to cut the filament off. Or pull it through the hole. Make sure there is no filament stuck in the mechanism before continuing. Another place to check for a clog is right here. This is where the filament loads into the machine and can sometimes find a piece of plastic sticking up and out of that. With your machine preheated, use needle nose pliers to pull it up if possible. If it's lower down in that, use your unclogging tool to push the filament through and out the other side. Notice this will be hot, so I am using the unclogging tool and not my fingers, so I do not burn myself. This should clear about any jam that you have in your Robo E3 Pro. If after that you still have a jam, you will need to exchange the nozzle for the spare that came with your 3D printer. To do that, you'll need a Phillips screwdriver, and you're going to remove the red heat shield from the bottom of your 3D printer. There is a screw on either side of the heat shield, so simply unscrew those, and we do recommend using a magnetic screwdriver to reduce the odds of losing these screws. Once it's released, you can simply and carefully pull it down. Now be mindful that your extruder is still very hot. Then use two pairs of pliers, one around the top of the block and one around the extruder itself, and untwist the extruder. Once it's been removed, take the unclogging tool and push it back through the top one more time. Take your replacement nozzle and repeat these steps in reverse order to put everything back together. When installing the new nozzle, make sure you tighten it very well. Reinstall the heat shield by pushing it up into place and securing with the screws. Reinstall the motor by putting it back into position and tightening the two screws on the front of the machine. Then replace the top cover, being careful to slide the wire on the side into the opening, and then tighten the three screws on the top to complete reassembly of your 3D printer. Once you've done that, you are ready to reload filament and get back to printing.